Okay, Boosie Badass. He wants to sue Mark Zuckerberg. He says that he wants to sue him for banning him from Instagram last August. Now, he told Vlad TV, who's also a government agent, that he made some of his business ventures go down, so he's suing him now. He's filing a lawsuit against him now. He stopped me off Instagram, and he didn't put me back on Instagram, and that's affected my business, you know? Mm. And this is the first time that he said that was the first time Instagram ever been taken from him, and so, you know, he wants to get, you know, his situation put back in order so he can, you know, get back to the bag as he was before. I mean, he's back on there, but, you know, you lose a little bit when they kick you off like that. So, good luck to you, Boosie. I'm sure you maybe have, you know, may have a lawyer too, but I'm sure he's going to have a lot more lawyers. So they might try to tie you up for quite some time. It's a game they like to play in the business world. Moving on, let's talk about JT from the City Girls. Ah, the things you say before you're famous will come back and haunt you trifold once you get on and popping. Now, there was a bunch of things she said, but here's the ones that got the people cooking her. She wrote, I love dark-skinned girls. Not too crispy, nah, but the milky ones be the ish. Now, she later addressed that tweet by saying, I was barely on Twitter last night and a fan sent the tweet and I removed it. Sorry if I offended anyone. I probably was arguing with somebody back then or some dumb stuff. I don't hate y'all or myself. I just be talking crap. And there was even trying to say something to the effect that she deactivated her Twitter and started a new one, and then she was making fun of the fact that she deactivated it on Instagram, and she posted a picture with a big bag. I'm sure it cost $98 million, and it was like, all my old tweets in this bag. Yeah.
But she's dark-skinned, and I don't, why would she even write something remotely close to that? I just don't understand.
The fact that people even put people's feet in the fire for things that they say on social media, especially like years ago, people change. Like, people say ignorant things when they while young, and then you get to a life where you grow a little bit, and then like you don't feel that way anymore. So
I get it, but I ain't never say nothing about black women.
Like, you know, that's you.
But yeah, no, I mean, that's your personal story.
Right. And being a black woman yourself, like, I just think that's dumb. That's like me dissing myself.
It was dumb. I think that's why she said I said dumb stuff back then, and I think she took ownership of it.
Well, that
right,
was
but
me.
I'm saying just to say it, period, doesn't make sense to me. I don't care.
No, by
what
me
was.
Saying that she most said dumb stuff back Twitter then was me say. Trying to like you know clean it up for everybody. But she's like she was probably arguing with somebody, and if you're arguing with somebody, you can't be held to task for what you say in the middle of an argument because you're gonna pull out all the heavy artillery to go at the person that you're going at. And if
she
people want to
just say
like,
who the specific person was. Crack. That's all you had to do. Say, hey man, the chick that worked at the drive-thru window that didn't put my order right, you bacon crispy black woman, you that's where specifically you was trying to be derogatory is what you're saying. So that's all good in the roast game.
Somebody's gonna take a snippet of that audio, Billy, and try to cancel you now. It's just how the world works. It's just where we're at in 2020. You know what I mean? Hey. But so
I say somebody, I'm not that famous yet.
I've seen people say worse, and I've seen people get canceled for less. So
yeah, you know, I mean, like, who's really truly canceled in 2020? Other than like, unless you're Bill Cosby, where you're in jail, you can't do anything, right?
Canceled.
Oh yeah, well he's in jail
Russell
too.
Simmons.
People will show up to anything that R. Kelly does.
Terry Crews. Like,
if R. Kelly did a concert tonight and he got right. out, there will be a whole bunch of weirdly shaped women there singing all them songs and there for it. I digress. MTV did the greatest of all times last night because they didn't do the MTV Movie and TV Awards. And the only really big thing to talk about is Kevin Hart got some props. He got an award for being the comedy giant. Take a listen.
Wow, huge, major thank you, MTV. I appreciate you guys so much. Comedy Giant Award. You know what? I'm going to take the award. I'm actually going to throw it back at my fans, man, because this doesn't happen without you guys. I'm going to say thank you all for supporting me, loving me, holding me down throughout all the years. This is big. I hate that I can't eat it. I wish I could eat it. If I could eat it, it would be great. It's great either way. 5'4" and now a giant. Thank you guys so much.
Some people will say that was funnier than the last special.
No,
also,
damn.
Chadwick Boseman also got the Hero for the Ages Award last night. You know, so big shout out to Chadwick Boseman and all the people that watched it.
We are the Morning Hustle.